I accepted the resignation of Vitaliano Aguirre, my fraternity brother, as Secretary of Justice.
With these words, President Duterte ended days of speculations on Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre's stay in the Duterte cabinet. But the announcement did not come as a surprise for many. This, especially as Palace Secretary Harry Roque earlier revealed, President Duterte had not been satisfied with the performance of some of his cabinet members and had been looking to replace some of them. Prior to Aguirre's resignation, there was already talk about his departure following the DOJ prosecutor's controversial decision to dismiss drug charges against Kerwin Espinosa and Peter Lim. This development angered the president, leading him to joke that Aguirre himself will replace Espinosa in jail should the latter be eventually set free. The Justice Secretary immediately ordered a fresh investigation on the case. However, more controversy sounded Aguirre after the DOJ placed pork barrel scam queen Janet Lim Napoles under its witness protection program. Despite mounting calls for his resignation, Malacañang said that the Justice Secretary still enjoyed the trust of the President.
Nakakausap po na ating Pangulo, and I could not feel that whiff of trust, no trust and confidence from him. But, and besides, there's no reason why I should resign because wala naman akong kasalanan. But even if wala akong kasalanan, if the President says so, o yun nga, nakaramdam ako na kulang na yung pagtitiwala sa akin, mabilis pa sa alas 4, resign tayo.
Senator Bam Aquino welcomes Aguirre's resignation, saying he has already lost his credibility due to recent controversies at the DOJ. Senator Risa Hontivero says Aguirre's departure from the DOJ is long overdue, accusing him of turning the department into a purveyor of fake news and tool against the opposition. But she adds, the move is a clear victory against injustice and impunity. Senator Grace Poe says Aguirre can still be held accountable for acts he committed when he was still Justice Secretary. Malacañang has not yet announced whether Aguirre would be appointed to another government post. But already, the party-list group Akbayan said Aguirre should not be given another public office. The group also said that the former justice chief should neither be allowed to run for Senate nor elected in the Supreme Court, following what it calls the public's overwhelming rejection of him. Meanwhile, almost immediately after his announcement of Aguirre's resignation, President Duterte installed Senior Deputy Executive Secretary Menardo Guevarra as his new Justice Secretary.
Eh, alam naman natin, kilala natin si Yusek Guevarra talaga namang napatunay ang kakayahan at kagalingan sa batas, no, at integridad ang meron si Secretary Guevarra. Take note that although he is Deputy Executive Secretary, he held the post of a cabinet member as well, no, here in Malacañang. So it's just a transfer of appointment from Office of the President to Department of Justice.
Guevarra, who is the right-hand man of Executive Secretary Salvador Medialdea, recently came to the public's attention when he served as Palace spokesman during the regular Palace briefing this week in place of Harry Roque, who was on leave. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.